ഗുരുഭ്യോ നമഃ. ഹരി ഓം. മോസ്റ്റ് ഹംബിൾ പ്രണാംസ് അറ്റ് ദ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ഫീറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ഡിവൈൻ മദർ സത്ഗുരു ശ്രീ മാത അമൃതാനന്ദമയി ദേവി, ആൻഡ് പ്രണാംസ് ടു ഓൾ ദ സീനിയർ സ്വാമീസ്, ആൻഡ് പ്രണാംസ് ടു ഓൾ ദ ഗ്രേറ്റ് സ്കോളേഴ്സ് ഹു ഹാവ് ഹു ആർ ഹിയർ ഫോർ ദിസ് കോൺഫറൻസ്. മൈ ടോപ്പിക് ഈസ് ഓൺ എ പേഴ്സൺ കോൾഡ് സ്വാമി Sri Narayana Gurudevan. About him, the president, our current president, in the 17th formation of 17th Lok Sabha, then in that speech he said, "New India will be formed on the basis of the teaching of Sri Narayana Gurudevan." This was his statement in the 17th comments of the first address to the parliament. This is what he said. So my research topic today is about the philosophy of Sri Narayana Gurudevan, his childhood, and his philosophy of Advaita, and about some academic thesis which says Swami is just a social reformer. So I'll start. The paper name is Advaita in the Teachings of Sri Narayana Gurudevan, a study based on his literary works. Guru was born in 1855 in Chembadanthi, near the capital, the current capital of Kerala, and his name was Narayana, and he was called adoringly by his parent as Nanu, and his father was actually a school teacher, and even his many of his relatives had good education, and Nanu, by the age of 30, he got good knowledge in Sanskrit and various other Hindu scriptures. Plus, he, from the beginning, he was very fond of spirituality, and he used to go deep into deep meditation, where he really go deep into the meditation. And there was a time when he met a person called Shanmugadas. Later, Shanmugadas became Chattambi Swami, the famous spiritual Hindu spiritual saint Chattambi Swami. Both were very close friends. Even Gurudevan considered Chattambi Swami as his guru even. But Chattambi Swami introduced to Gurudevan a saint called Thaikkattaiyavu from Tamil Nadu. And Narayana Guru went to Thaikkattaiyavu Swami's place and learned Hatha Yoga. And after learning Hatha Yoga, he went to Maruthuvamalai, and he stayed there for nearly 6 years doing penance for 6 years. And after that, the Nanu who went to Maruthuvamalai came back to Kerala as a person called Sri Narayana Gurudevan and started writing many philosophical work. For instance, his works include Atmopadesha Shatakam, Advaita Deepika, Darshanamala, Vedanta Sutra, and many other works as well. And even he translated major Hindu texts like Ishavasya Upanishad, Tirukkural. And next is the philosophy of Narayana Gurudevan. In his own words, what he says is what his philosophy is nothing but what he have to say was what Shankara has said, courtesy Narayana Gurudevan's Shishya Nataraja Guru noted this in his Life and Teachings of Narayana Guru. And in an academic thesis which I came across, he said that in his Atmopadesha Shatakam, Advaita Deepika and Darshanamala, he profounds the philosophy of Advaita effectively and also conveyed the idea that the aim of such a realization is also a search for happiness, and that happiness and joy that one gains in life should be helpful to others as well. If we see the life of Gurudevan, we will be able to understand that he was someone who spiritualized the entire Kerala, who spiritualized the mankind regardless of caste, color or creed. And when I searched for oneness in his teachings, I could find in many of his writings this aspect of Advaita, or the aspect of awareness, or the aspect of oneness was there. This is from Advaita Deepika, verse number 1, where he says, in Malayalam, it's actually a Malayalam verse, Perayiram Pravartiyayiram, and this sloka is verse number 1, the meaning is, names in their thousand, mental images in their thousand, and corresponding inevitably emerging objects in their thousands, these together constitute the world. As long as not reflected on properly, it seems real. just as dream persists to seem real so long as the dreamer does not awaken. But when he awakens, the entire dream becomes merged into himself. And in another work of his, Atmopadesha Shatakam, verse number 4, which says, Arivum arinjidunavan, Arivum arinjidunavan arthavum puman. In the last line of this verse, Arivil amarnu adu matram ayidenam. Arivil amarnu adu matram ayidenam. The translation in English is like, knowledge, its meaning, known, and the personal knowledge, subjective, together make but one primal glory within the unerified radiance of this great knowledge. One should merge and become that alone. And even the oneness, the philosophy of oneness or the philosophy of Advaita can be seen in his Darshanamala as well, where he says, he from whom, like a fig tree as from seed, came out this world manifested. He is Brahma, he is Shiva, he is Vishnu. He is the ultimate, everything is he indeed. And when we look at the life of Swami Sri Narayana Gurudev, we'll be able to understand that he was not someone who just preached the Advaita philosophy. He lived it. I quote an anecdote from his life where Chattambi Swami met him after his transformation and becoming the guru of Kerala, or a famous guru. When he met him, he asked quite teasingly to Narayana Guru, now you have become a man of action. The Malayalam word he used is pravartiyaru, you became a pravartiyaru. And for this, Guru replies to Chattambi Swami, yes, pravarti is there, but no are. Doer is there, the action is there, but no doer. So he was someone who understood the philosophy and he has lived the philosophy. And certain tributes by certain great people on Narayana Guru, Mahatma Gandhi have met him, and this is his statement. I feel it is a great privilege in my life to have visited the beautiful state of Travancore and to have a darshan of venerable sage Sri Narayana Guru. I had the fortune to stay for one day in his holy ashram. Even the Empress of Trivandrum at that time spoke great things about Gurudev. Rabindranath Tagore, after meeting him, wrote this, I have been touring different parts of the world. During this travel, I have had fortune to come across in contact with several saints and Maharishis, but I have frankly to admit that I have never seen one who is spiritually greater than Swami Narayana Guru of Malayalam. And this is what Mother Amrutanandamayi Devi says about Gurudevan. When we see the untruth as truth and adharma as dharma, social life falls astray. Gurudevan is a Mahatma who saved an entire society that was starting to drift off course. Narayana Guru's power came from his detachment. Because of this, he was able to start a spiritual revolution that initiated the purification and transformation of society. Only karma yogis like him can bring about a real change in the society. Now, I came across a thesis which says, the guru laid the foundation of all progress in reformation of religious practices, social custom, and daily habits of the people. This thesis is by Baby Sujada of Department of Philosophy, University of Calicut. I see a problem in this sentence. Why? Because reformation is something which is attached with the colonial mindset, which has experience of reformation from Martin Luther. Martin Luther did the reformation. He formed a different sect called Protestant Christianity, and there was something called Catholic Christianity. And the Britishers too had the same view that Hinduism is something which needs reformation, so that there is a particular, and they believed, or they even propagated, that Hinduism is an outdated thing and Buddhism is the reformed version of Hinduism. So if you closely look at this statement in the thesis and the tribute statements of Tagore and Mata Amrutanandamayi Devi, they too are saying what Guru was actually a spiritual person, a Vedanti who uplifted mankind. Apart from being someone who transformed the society socially, his main contribution was he was a Vedanti, an Advaita Vedanti. So if that is not given to Gurudev and now, and if we started to propagate Guru as just a social reformer, that means it's actually that act itself will reduce whatever he has done to the society. Now, he was someone who, regardless of caste and creed, has uplifted mankind. He is someone who lived Advaita Vedanta. So there is an attempt to reduce or even marginalize his work, to just claim or promote him as just a social reformer. So I see this as a colonial, this kind of thesis as a thesis which comes from the colonial mindset. Swamiji in the last session said why we should really consider Pollock, why should we give prominence to Pollock? It's not about giving prominence to Pollock. If we didn't counter those kind of arguments which is being produced by Pollock and his team or people from the West like Vinny Noniger. If we didn't counter it, what we people from the academia will read majority of those theses and we'll believe that that's fact. So I believe that there should be a counter argument produced or else our own saints will later become like social reformer who have done, just minimal work. So this is my thesis on Gurudevan. Thank you all.